Imagine a world, we're in a post-apocalyptic world where you're scavenging for supplies on a daily basis. You're looking for food. You're looking for things that'll provide comfort and health and support to you living. All these things. No, we're not talking about Walking Dead. We're talking about Black Mirror, Season 4, Episode 5, Metalhead. We're going to discuss a little bit further.
Do you love binge watching series and movies like I do? Well, head on over to The Streaming Lifestyle, where there you can find the latest blogs, news, and product reviews that match up with your favorite apps such as Netflix, Hulu, and Amazon Prime Instant Video. So go head on over there and check them out.
Oh, man, this show is the only show this season that's shot in black and white, and I think they use it for a great effect for this particular episode. What we're doing with you is a bunch of scavengers that are looking for supplies that are away from the base camp in this post-apocalyptic world, and what they're searching for are a bunch of food, supplies, and other things. Now, in this world, we find out technology-wise, it being Black Mirror, that there are these things called dogs, and these dogs are like these, I don't know why, but they're these kind of security or like a security system, but honestly, in this particular world, it's beyond that. These are not just security system things, like you would have, like let's say you had a dog at home, like a Rottweiler or something, or a Great Dane, I don't know, something in your backyard or in your front yard to help protect you. These things are like Terminator-wide dogs. Like, if you activate these things, they completely go after you. So this turns into a, what's going on, Black Mirror episode, to, oh man, they're scavenging, they're looking for something, I wonder what's going on, to there it turns into a straight horror movie in about, like, 4 minutes. So, 4 minutes of the episode, one of the dogs gets activated, and you see that this actual savage group is attacked, and this thing is vicious. It goes after him. It starts just attacking and killing people and killing things, and it's like non-stop, it's unstoppable. So we follow the majority of the episode of one of the survivors, how she communicates to base camp and just giving messages to base camp, telling them what's happening, telling them they encountered one of the dogs. And this is his plan to survive throughout the entire episode. So this episode is very basic. It's pretty much a horror movie for an hour or something, or something like that, 45 minutes, 50 minutes. But it's a straight up like survival story for this series, not this show. If it's that may be kind of slow for you guys that are looking for like this character development and all that stuff, but if this particular actually like the fact that they put this show, that this is part of the collection of season 4, because it's just a different pacing from the other shows. Like the last show, actually, all the shows previous to Metalhead, which is the title, if I didn't say it, this episode, Metalhead, is this season 4, episode 5. This particular episode is a different pacing. I don't want to say as far as that, there's a lot of, I said pacing is probably wrong here. As far as the story content and the character development, it's a lot. But the actual pacing and the fear and the claustrophobia and all those elements, that's what takes place in this particular episode that's different than the other one. Now, with that being said, the technology is obviously the dog. These scratching, hunting, speaking, deadly, they're made of metal. Strong metal, apparently. Dogs gotta come after you to I guess end or annihilate or stop whatever the thing is that they're letting it that has activated. Okay? So that's pretty much what's going on with this episode. So going on to the climax of the episode, she gets trapped and you figure out how she's trying to attack the dog at I protect herself from the dog and try to defeat him so she can get back to her her group that she's contacting. That is pretty much how the episode wraps up. And I'm leaving out some details, especially I'm leaving out the twist ending, because there is definitely two twist endings to this. And look for a special note to what the group was looking for in the first place. I think you find that quite interesting. And anyway, that's that episode. So, what do I think about it? Obviously, it sounds like I did like it. I liked it. Jordan, I give it like two thumbs up. I give it my recommendations. Check it out. It's for those of you that don't like the less character development, like full blown like story and lots of dialogue. There is not much of that. There's dialogue at the beginning. It's a little tiny in the middle, a little tiny at the end, but it's mostly puffing and panting and running and screaming and yelling and all that junk, as he would be saying, trying to kill you or hunt you down or whatever you want to call it. So, that may not appeal to some people. So, for those crowds, you might find this a little bit weaker than other episodes. For those that like that, I've seen a lot of other people say that this is their favorite episode of the season. So, go ahead and please do three things for me. Number one, leave a comment down below just to mention if you've seen this episode or not, or if you plan on seeing it. Two, go ahead and hit that bell notification so you're notified, so you're notified when we actually release new content. And three, go ahead and check out www.thestreaminglifestyle.com or hit on that link down below to go to our companion blog site. Once again, mention again that we will, so that you can go ahead and see what more content. If there's more content posted up there, then there's a lot of them. There's other for us to pump out on YouTube. You can go ahead and check that out and you'll be interested in seeing new stuff. There's more like news, product reviews, more like rumors of things, because I don't want to get into rumors on the actual YouTube channel, just talking about things that we know that's out that we've seen or things like that. But rumors, whatever. The point is, check it out. You'll find it worthwhile, valuable for you. If you enjoy it, so you're fine. We salute you, see you on the next one. Peace.